and these construction sites in the city of Philadelphia, they may not talk about apartheid, but it really does truly exist. Mayor Michael Mutter said that he will try to gentrify the construction sites. Well, guess what? People of color are not wanted on these construction sites.
No, I'm not.
They're not wanted on these apprenticeship programs.
No, I'm not.
They're not wanted to build the city of Philadelphia. And we would think that unions, construction unions, would actually be progressive.
Yeah.
They started out as progressive movements. Guess what? They no longer are progressive.
Nope.
Because instead of fighting to stop the war, instead of fighting to understand other workers' struggles, they only understand that they think they're a bunch of prima donnas and they're only for themselves. Well, guess what? In disunity, you will also be disunited. So it's time that you unite against the war, that you unite and realize that no immigrant is illegal, and that they are all immigrants, and that they are legal. Everyone, no one's an illegal in this country. If they decide to build a country, Comcast, I don't care if they are government jobs, I don't care if they don't have any government money at all. 40%, at least 40% of these neighborhood jobs should go to the people in the neighborhood. South Philly, where they're from, they should represent the community that they're from. They should be working in North Philly.
Yes.
And there's some brother at 22nd and Diamond, he should be working on job sites.
Right.
That's
the
guy that's blue eye and blonde hair. Give me a fucking break. Grow up and learn how to stop hating people. Start liking people. How long are we going to be fighting each other? We are not the problem. Workers are not the problem. It's the government that has to understand that all workers are united in a struggle. But you know, that 1% is always trying to screw things up. We represent the really what democracy is all about. And that's why we're here.
Salary up to $31.4 million.
anymore. But then Comcast seems intent on shedding its cable connection, lest it stand in the way of acquiring Time Warner Cable. Lots of Comcast users shell out $200 a month for the company's questionable services, but this is not the primary source of Comcast wealth that allowed it to buy NBC and potentially Time Warner. Now we're finding out from FCC leaks that by taking over Time Warner, Comcast would have total control of access to the internet. Are we going to let that happen? To buy this building and this merger was by stealing tax dollars from programs that were intended to benefit the poor. In 2005, Comcast Center went to then Governor Ed Rendell and was granted $43 million in state assistance intended for low income. He slept with single family poverty. It was intended to build low-income houses and businesses, but instead it built this tower that's behind us. No doubt it helped that Comcast Executive Vice President David Cohen was a close confidant of Rendell's, having served as finance director when Rendell was mayor of Philadelphia.
Boils down to less than 200 super wealthy individuals who are